Hello children, how are you? I am Suchita Dubey from Holy Hearts Educational Academy, Raipur. Once again back with the topic caring and sharing. Children, you always want to keep your house clean. You always want to wear the clean clothes. You always want to keep your toys safe. You always wash your car regularly. Why is it so? It is because these all things belongs to you. These are your belonging. So the things that belong to a single person or owned by a particular person are called as private property, like house, car, clothes, toys, etc. And it's a duty of that person or the family members to maintain all these things. Then what about the things that are used outside, like road, park, school, hospitals, bus, trains, etc. Who built all these things? So the things that are built by the government and used by all are called as public property, like park, road, hospital, schools, bus, train, historical monuments, etc. The things that are built by the government and used by the all are called as public property. Then how does these public properties are maintained? Do you know how? We always pay the road tax, we pay the property tax and the entertainment tax, through which the money raised and that money is used for the maintenance of these public property. So being a responsible citizen of this country, it's our duty to maintain all these public property. Let's see how we should take care of the public property one by one. So the first public property is the school. Students, as you know that the school provides you so many facilities like desks and benches for sitting, blackboard chalk for learning and writing, there are computers in your lab for the learning, there are library books for reading over there, and drinking water facility. So it's our duty that we should keep our school property well maintained. How to keep it? Now let's study one by one. Do not scratch on the desks. Do not write anything on the school walls. Maintain your class. That should not be dirty. Always keep the garbage in the dustbin. Always switch off the lights and fan whenever you are going outside of your class. Do not waste the drinking water. Do not break the lights or damage the school property. So in this way, you can maintain your school property. Secondly, the playground where you spend most of the time while playing. So always use your playing equipments very finely. Then do not pluck the flowers from your school garden. In this way, you can maintain your school property. Second public property that we are going to discuss is public park. A number of public parks in the city or town are maintained by the government. Every colony is also having a park which is maintained by RWA. Senior citizens and people love to take walk over here. Children like to play every evening. These parks are the source of great enjoyment. It is our duty to help the government in maintaining the park and follow the rules written here. Taking care of public parks, we must not pluck flowers or leaves or destroy the grass in the park. We must not litter the park with the waste paper, bottles or packets. We always throw the garbage in the dustbin. We must plant more and more trees or plant in the surrounding areas. Next public property that we are going to discuss is public transport. We all use the various means of public transport to travel from one place to another, like bus, car, aeroplanes, etc. Everyone would like to travel in the clean and comfortable trains or buses, so we should always maintain it and we should not misuse it. How to take care of this public transport? We should not litter the trains or buses we travel in. We should not tear, cut or scratch the seats. We should not break the electric fitting or the toilet facilities. We should not spit or stick any unwanted things on it. We should not break or damage the windows or doors. Next is historical monuments. As you know that India is the well known for the historical monuments. It's our pride. These monuments are the part of our cultural heritage. So it's our duty to maintain all these historical monuments. How should we take care of these? We must not scribble or scratch the monuments. We must not damage or disfigure them. We must not litter the monuments or its surrounding areas. We must not spit on the walls of the monument. So being a responsible citizen, it's our duty that as we take care of our private property, in the same manner we should take care of the public property.